Hey, it's Andrew here from Home Theatre Engineering. I'm 4,000 kilometres from home at least. I'm in Tasmania and I'm in the home of Kim and Mel, and they've asked me to come over and tidy up some issues with the home theatre. So first of all, let's take a tour around the room. This is the view as you come in. You can see the seats. We've got three at the front. We've got the center seat converts into like a table and a USB platform. We've got four seats across the back that have been judiciously moved off the back wall. We can see the rear speakers and also the JVC N7, and up in the ceiling we can see the Atmos speakers as well. A little bit wide, but you know, we can work with that. And then as we come around, we can see the tower speakers, golden ear, and also golden ear for left, centre and right.
Now let's have a look at the rack. So we're looking at the MC525 power amp, we're looking at the MRX 1120 Anthem, Fetch TV, Foxtel IQ4 and the Pioneer UDP disc player, and a really lovely bar setup as well. Also the bar, it has a roller door that comes down that blocks off all the light and noise, and on the other side of the room we have the same thing. We have this incredible roller door setup, and whilst that's challenging for acoustics, the feature actually looks really lovely in the room, and I quite like it. It's fantastic. There's a fabric front wall much along the lines of the ones that we do, and behind that are the LCR speakers and one subwoofer. So collectively we're running effectively five subwoofers in this room.
So why am I here? Well, they had the room built and they never felt it was quite right. They paid for calibration apparently, and this is an interesting point and I'll get to that. So what have I done? What makes it of any value, me being here? So first of all, we went through the system with a fine-tooth comb, and would you believe one of the things that we found in this system is the sender's channel was turned off. Heavens knows why. That is like home theatre 101. Why you would turn your sender channel off for general use, I have no idea. Anyway, turn that back on. Atmos speakers set up incorrectly. The Atmos was set to Dolby, middle and rear, whereas they're actually in ceiling, front and back. So we fixed that up as well. Distances were not set, all set at default 3.6 meters, and levels made no sense whatsoever. Quite a few other issues, got them sorted. Installed a mini DSP, then worked on the room modes, had a look at how the sound is propagating in the room and decided what to use in terms of the speakers. Because these golden ears have subs built into them, I have to consider each one of them a subwoofer. And so I went through and made sure they weren't cancelling each other out, make sure they're all time aligned. And so they were run by a coax back to the mini DSP, and I doubled up one channel, so I've got five subwoofers running off the mini DSP, but it enabled me to align those. So the left and rights were run off the one channel because they're the same distance from the front, and then I could handle everything else individually. Once I was really happy with that, I had a look at the EQ in the room. Because they're golden ears, they're ribbon tweeters, and they're a little bit harsh, especially when you've got several of them running. And you can actually see as you turn on more and more speakers, the high frequencies, because it can live in the room, would pick up energy. And so we created a bit of a house curve, just rolled those off. This is one of the beauties of Anthem Arc Genesis, by the way. So first of all, I did a manual calibration. I set up everything as much as I possibly could manually, made sure the room is as good as I can, so that the Arc Genesis has as little to do as possible. And then I run the Arc Genesis and then I validate it afterwards. The beauty of the Arc Genesis is that you really can tailor and customize things like high frequency roll-off or bass management, etc. So any final polish that I just needed to add was all there in the Anthem Arc Genesis. And I created three profiles as well, one for the main seat, one for the front row, and then one for all seats occupied. So I took a whole set of lots of measurements to create those profiles for them. So that sorted out the sound. Then we came to the picture. The JVC was looking pretty sad for some reason. So there are two calibrations that you can run. One is internal. So JVC has their own calibration software. You need either an i1 Pro or a Spider X, and you then run that software. and they are notorious for having a bit of a gamma bump, and the reds on this were a bit eh, so we sorted all that out first. So again, got a baseline internally in the equipment, and then ran my Calman calibration. Now, when I got here, I had a bit of a freak out because my Calman software said my license wasn't valid. I checked online, it was. I've been using the same laptop for a long time. Why it should suddenly turn off, I don't know. So I started firing off panicky emails to the US. It was after hours. The customer standing here waiting for me, not good. Anyway, thank you to the guys at Portrait Displays, Mackenzie and Tyler Pruitt. Appreciate your help, really, guys. I'm sorry I fired up such a panicky email, but you can imagine if someone's paying you to be here and you can't do anything, that's a concern. Anyway, all sorted, up and running, and the calibration worked. We got it done. Rec 709 calibration was phenomenal. Like, out of this JVC, I got 0.75 delta E, and that is really cool. Like, below one is a good target from pretty much anything. So that is exceptional. The colours and those are pinpoint accurate. The black levels have improved. We've got the adaptive frame-by-frame tone mapping happening. And it's looking really, really good. It's a large screen, 150-inch. I have recommended they put a lens in because it's kind of struggling a little bit with the HDR. And of course, you're throwing away all those great pixels, which is a shame, especially in a room like this. And they are running a Stuart film screen, so, you know, they've got all the gear to make it look really, really good. I guess the question is, again, why me? Why here? And this is a problem. So, you know, the person who had installed the Cinnamon guided them kind of ran out of steam and reached a point where they didn't really know what to do next. That's fair enough. Look, you know, it's great to help customers, but, you know your limitations. And I think at the end of the day, you know, they had apparently, so I've been told, charged them for calibration. The guy hasn't got the equipment. He's not certified. Look, putting numbers into an AVR is not calibration, guys. It's basic home theatre setup. That is not calibration. You know, calibration is fine adjustment with the correct tools, you know, and working to the nth degree to extract every bit of performance out of a room. Just doing a setup is kind of no different to winding up the windows in your car and turning on your ignition. It's fundamental, right? Making sure your tire pressure's there. That is not high-level tuning. So, these people knew that something was lacking in their cinema. They asked around, they got us, they've flown me over here, and the result is really spectacular. And here's to my point. Calibration is a component of a home theatre, like an amplifier, like a projector, like a screen, like speakers. If you're building a home theatre of any value, then when you're picking the stuff off the shelf for it, you know, you grab your speakers, you grab your projector, you grab your amplifier, you should be grabbing something called calibration and adding that to your budget. It's one of the cheaper components you'll buy, you know, and yet it's the one that will extract the very most out of your system. Why wouldn't you do it? It just doesn't make sense, right? So, you know, buy your Ferrari, you know, drive it off the lot, hasn't been tuned, will only go 30 kilometres an hour, engine's running rough. Nothing wrong with the vehicle, it just hasn't been tuned. Why you would build a home theatre and not extract the most performance out of it leaves me boggled. And the thing is, the customers knew it. They knew that something wasn't quite right. They knew that this thing wasn't working the way they felt it should. And every customer is the same. It's normally a year or two after the job's finished, then they ring us up and say, we're still not happy, something's not right, and we come in. But to find things like center channel not working, Atmos not assigned properly, no distances, no levels, man, you know, that just shouldn't be happening anywhere. Not anywhere. There shouldn't be any need for my services for home theatre engineering for us to exist. We shouldn't be needed, you know. So if you are building a home theatre and you're with a company and they say, you know, here's your installation, here's your equipment, and here's calibration, ask them, who's calibrating? What are their qualifications? What equipment have they got? And if you want, call us and we'll help verify that. We'll help verify that they've got the equipment that they need. Normally, if it's a calibrator, we'll know them. And, you know, most of the guys out there are really good. So do it. Get your system calibrated, audio and video. It's well worth it. It is the best addition. It's the best component you will add to your cinema, hands down, absolutely every single time. I mean, hey, we haven't had an unhappy customer in 20 years. Like, what does that tell you? You know, everybody has been blown away by what calibration will do to the home theatre. I don't think they realise how far you can lift, you know, the performance of a room. Anyway, enough of raving from me. It's been really great here. I just want to say a massive thank you to Kim and Mel. The hospitality here has been amazing. The family is wonderful. They're lovely, lovely people. I'm actually going to not enjoy leaving here. But we're also here for them. You know, we're sort of like Home Theatre Google. If they need any questions answered, if they have any problems, they just pick up the phone, email or text us. And, you know, now as part of the Home Theatre Engineering family, they will get looked after and we will help them through in the future. So that's what it's all about, really. It's about knowing that, you know, you're being taken care of, questions are being answered. So thank you once again for joining us. It's been really great working here. It's been really great doing this quick tour of the room and especially doing the calibration. And I'm packing up and ready to head off to the next job.